Hello, everybody. I'm Gemma, and today I'm going to share with you a very hands-on talk on how to unleash the power of GA4 for B2B companies. So let's go. Let's start from the beginning. 3 years ago, Google said that they were introducing a new Google Analytics, a tool that will help us to get a better understanding on our website data, a tool that will help us to understand more the customers, a tool that will help us to have a better ROI. I mean, that's amazing, right? However, I don't know if they are achieving their objective, or at least this is not the perception within the industry. Last month, Barry Suarez, he did this poll asking about what users think about GA4, and out of almost 2,000 people, half of them said that they hate this tool, and only 5% actually loved it. So what's happening here? I work on an agency, and we've been using the tool for some months now, and especially for B2B clients. And on one side, I agree that the tool can be really good, but there are still some things that might need to be improved. Because, for example, it's true that if the tool is not correctly set up, it can be very useless. And not only useless, a little bit frustrating and confusing too. I mean, has it ever happened to you that you know that only 5 form submissions have been sent to you, but the tool says that you have received 20? Sometimes it makes no sense. However, after using it for a few months, I have to admit that it can be very useful, and you can use it to do great reports and get the data that you really need to focus your strategies. So let's go. How to properly analyze and recollect data for B2B companies via GA4? First of all, GA4, it's organized by different reports. And first, we find the acquisition report. The acquisition report, for me, is a little bit similar, like the ones that we were used to on Universal Analytics. And basically, it's divided into 2 big groups. User acquisition, that shows us how we acquire our users for the first time, and traffic acquisition. This is more on a session level. On the report, we can play and with the dimensions and analyze everything related to how we acquire the users. However, the situation starts to change when we move on to the next report, the engagement report, that for me it's like the most useful and important one here, especially the events and conversion report. Events, important to point out, are the metric that allow us to know how users interact with our website. Like, for example, when somebody clicks on a link or for when somebody downloads a file. And the conversions are basically these events that we want to highlight because maybe they are priority for our business. Okay, so we are a B2B company, we go to GA4, we go to the events, and we see what's happening here. There are some events collected by default by the tool. That's great, isn't it? However, maybe for us, these events are not even important, or maybe they are not our priority. So, how to track the ones that are really a priority for us, for a B2B company? First of all, first step, define which are your KPIs. Mostly, I especially work for B2B companies. These are 4 really important KPIs that we use for almost all of our clients. File downloads, for when somebody downloads a file, either it's a technical data sheet or some instructions. Video reproduction, for when user views a video related to our machines. Form submissions, for when somebody requests a budget. And last but not least, generate lead. This is when for somebody asks for more information about something, like, for example, they send an email to us or they call us. Basically, these KPIs are found at the end of the conversion funnel. Of course, there are more, but usually these 4 are really important for us and for this kind of companies. However, what's happening here? You go to the event report on GA4, and none of that KPIs are being tracked here. So what do we have to do now? How can we track them? We'll have to set them up. And this is something very important, and I think it's like the key thing on GA4 is like, if we want to analyze our KPIs and our things that could be more relevant for our business, we'll have to set everything up. So, first of all, important to point out, and this is like the big difference, I think, from Universal Analytics. Before, how did we track the events? Universal analytics offer category, action, and label events. And from here, we classify. They didn't give you like recommendations on how to do it. You were like, OK, let's do it however you want. Now, in GA4, they, in a nice way, offer recommendation on how to classify our events. But I think that sometimes this can be confusing. They offer four different kinds of event classification. The automatically collected ones, that are these ones that we saw before. Enhanced measurement, they are almost automatically also events. We just need to activate them. Recommended events, there are like 50 recommended events, and they are divided depending on the kind of business that you work on. And last but not least, custom events. These ones are like the ones that you need to set your app on your own. But how this translates into our B2B KPIs? So this is the image. Let's take a closer look at them. File downloads, video reproductions, and form submissions. They are all enhanced measurement events, the ones that are almost automatically to track. I mean, 3 out of 4 B2B events are in the same category, so this is going to be easy, isn't it? How to do this? We just need to go to admin data streams and enable these 3 events that appear there. After that, you need to wait a few days, always when collecting information, because maybe they are not tracking in the same moment. And then you can also mark them as conversions, and so they will not only appear on the event report, but also on the conversion report. And boom, you will have all the data that you need, at least from these 3 events. I mean, it's faster, easier than on Universal Analytics. So easy, right? However, after doing this with all my clients, sometimes I realized that sometimes things don't work out so easily. And I think this is a problem why people are so confusing and frustrating with the tool. Because sometimes this image happens. You go to the book view, this is where you go to see if it's working, what you are trying to trigger, and nothing is happening. Why this happens? Sometimes due to how the website is built, due to some specialty plugins, some events are not triggered in a more automatical way. And this happened to me at least with half of my clients. So I understand why half of the users say that they hate the tool. So what to do in these cases? Especially, I mean, if you work on an agency, maybe it will happen to you because the probability that this happened to one client is very high. So what now? Well, we need to go to our go-to source tool for these cases, Google Tag Manager. It's like Universal Analytics. In these cases, what's the best thing to do? Even though they are almost automatically collected events, or at least GA4 says so, the best thing to do is you can use the same name as they are recommending, for example, file download or form submission, but you need to create your triggers and your labels. Here I leave you some, so later you can, if you want to do it, you can do it. And you can do all of this by pre-built variables from Google Tag Manager. So usually it's very fast and it's like on Universal Analytics. However, I have to admit that even though you do this with the pre-built variables from Google Tag Managers, sometimes it wouldn't work either, especially for form submissions. In these cases, you can do other options to track these events, like for example, thank you page. You can track a thank you page after somebody sent a form submission. Or for example, or at, the last option that you have is you need to create everything on your own, like the variable, the trigger, and the tag by analyzing the data layer on Google Tag Manager if all the other options don't work. And last but not least, we also said generate lead. Generate lead, as Google says, it's a recommended event. What does it mean this? That they recommend you to do it. And they say that generally it's for when somebody asks for information. But what is this for me? For example, for me, for my B2B clients, it's for when somebody calls, sends an email from the website, maybe clicks on a chat. But maybe for you, for your type of client, for your priorities, it's not this. So maybe then the best thing to do is to create your own events. Like for example, click phone, click email, click chat. So then, after this, you will be able, now you will have the events that are a priority for B2B companies. And you will be able to create fantastic reports like, for example, these ones, and to know exactly how many files have been downloaded from your website, or how many form submissions. Okay, first conclusion here. For me, which is the most important part of the event part, now we will go on. Google recommends you to do it in a way, but sometimes due to how your website is built, some plugins, it won't work out. So you could get very frustrated. It happened to me some months ago, and you need to figure it out that there are so many other ways. So know what you want and know that maybe this way won't work, and you are not the first ones that happened this to you. So there are other options out there on how to track these events. But what if we want more? What if it's not enough to know how many forms have the user submitted, but to know which ones? What if we want to know which file downloads have the users download? Well, we can go further with the parameters. Parameters are like actions and labels, a little bit maybe from before, from Universal Analytics. What are parameters? Parameters provide additional information about events, events that then can be conversions. Like, for example, parameters offer us the option to know the name of the product that somebody viewed or which file download have they download. Like the events, Google GA4 offers some automatically collected parameters, like in a nice way. These five, I mean, it's amazing. Language, page location, page repair, page title. So in a more automatical way, we know all of this about our automatical events. However, and not only this, they recommend a list of parameters to use for enhanced measurement events and a list of parameters to use for recommended events. Like, for example, for video engagement, they recommend to use video title, video duration. For file downloads, they recommend to use a parameter file name, file extension, link ID. For form submission, they recommend to use form name, form ID, and not only for the ones that I'm talking about. They recommend a lot of parameters. What are we learning here? That they offer five automatical parameters, but there are so many, many, many more. And not only that, if we go to Google Tag Manager and we concrete analyze this action, like for example, a link click or a form submission, we can figure it out, more parameters, more dimensions that we want to analyze and include it to analyze this event. So what I'm trying to say here, Google in a nice way offers some options, but there are so many more. So don't stick only with the ones that the tool offers and try to dig more on what do you really want about this. For example, if you have all the files on the same page, do you care to know from which page the user downloaded the file? Maybe not. But if you have a different file for each product on each page, maybe you want to know all the page URLs from where the user have downloaded the file. So maybe this parameter is useful in this occasion. So define what you want and then try to get out the most of it. At the end, I leave a link for some recommended parameters for the B2B events that I mentioned before. So now we can go and how to set them up, the automatic ones via GA4 and the other ones via Google Tag Manager. And now we can go further on the analysis of our data and not only know how many file downloads the user have downloaded, but to know exactly which ones, which is kind of interesting because then here we can play with other, I don't know, from the acquisition channel that we acquire those users or things like that. Events, conversions, and parameters will enable us to analyze what's happening in an in-depth and proper way on our website. But GA4 offers so much more. Let's go to see that. For example, these are like not like the four most important events for a B2B companies, but for example, there are other events that I found that are also very interesting. Set results event. This is an enhanced measurement event. This is very easy usually to set up. I've never had problems with any client. And why to use this one? In this one, we can analyze what users search on our website browser. Why is this useful for us? Because, for example, then we can divide it by countries and analyze the most popular search terms depending on the region. Why do so? Because maybe we discover new content that maybe can help us to create new strategies, or maybe we can refocus the website architecture in some countries because we realize that people on that region look more for some concrete product. And not only that, this is another event that I think that is really interesting on B2B companies. I call it product comparison. It's a customized event, so you can name it however you want. And it, for example, and why do so? If, for example, we can analyze which products users compare between them the most. And we realize that product A and product C are very frequently compared. Why this will help us to, for example, to create new content, like which is the difference between this and this, or do a video, a blog, something. So try these events are useful for this too. But there's more than events and conversions and parameters on GA4 that can help us to drive into good conclusions for our SEO strategies. For example, thanks to the good configuration of parameters, we can analyze our 404 pages performance in a very fast and in deep way. We just need to go, in this case also, engagement report, page and screens, and by the page title parameters, as it's properly set up, we can look into this and very fast know how this page is performing. And not only that, some other tips that I think that are very useful from this tool is like Google Search Console. Before on Universal Analytics, Google Search Console reports were like automatically integrated on the tool. Now, they are not automatically integrated on the tool. As I mentioned before, there are a lot of things that we need to set up, but it's like so easy to include it. We just need to go to library and publish it. I mean, the first time it's like, why this report is not here? A lot of things are here, but they are not just published. We just need to go there, publish it, and we will have all the Search Console reports, if we want, on our GA4 account. And what else I think is very interesting about the new GA4? The last things. The explorations, that there's going to be a fantastic talk after mine about explorations, I think. Why to use explorations? For example, because we can play with different kind of data. If you go here, that can be useful depending, like, you know, mixing channels. I basically do SEO, but thanks to the explorations, I can use like other channels, campaigns, and design my strategies. For example, I go to explorations and I do reports such as Google Ads queries. This is what users look into their browser on Google. Keyword ads, keyword text ads, it's what a person on a campaign said, I want that my ads appear with this keyword. And then I mix them with session, conversions, etc. Why do this? Because this helps me maybe discover new queries that can be interesting for my campaigns. To create new SEO, new content, like new blogs, new videos, because there are also queries, concepts that users look when they are looking into my products and that maybe I didn't realize that they could be important for me. For example, well, this is in Spanish, but this is some different keyword, but it helped me to understand that maybe Google also relates those keywords and this can be interesting too for my campaign. So explorations are very good and help you to do this kind of reports, and also they allow you to compare different audiences, different segments of audience. So to finish my talk, unleashing the audiences. Audiences is also something that is like a key factor on GA4, and I really recommend you to set them up. How to set them up? In a nice way, also GA4 offers some templates on how to set up audiences. My recommendations, don't do so. I mean, create the ones that are really a priority for your business. For example, if before we define our KPIs, from here, define your audiences and know which are your main target and do these ones. For example, Google Demo account. I don't know if you ever go there, but in their GA4 Demo account, they have a lot of different audiences, not only the templates one, so maybe it's a good idea. Why? Because this will help you to analyze users with similar interests, similar behaviors, similar attributes, and then you will be able to create more customized content to know how users interact with your website and to offer a better experience. And last but not least, to do remarketing ads, as if you target, if you analyze in a proper way all your website with events, conversions, and parameters, it's going to be very easy to do this. So, to sum up, GA4, It's true that maybe it's not the more intuitive tool, as not all data of interest is displayed by default. On the other side, most of this data needs to be set up manually if you really want to get out the most of the tool. So my recommendation when using it, don't get overwhelmed by all the options that the tool is offering. Don't just stay with the perception that sometimes maybe it's on Twitter about the tool. Define what you want. It's like, okay, I need those KPIs, how to translate it into events and conversions, and identify which is the best way for you to set them up. Like, it's via GA4, it's enough. Maybe I need Google Tag Manager to properly collect my data. Because if you identify exactly what you need, and maybe what you don't need, for example, in my case, what I was talking now, I don't need advertising reports or monetization reports right now. So let us stick on what we need. Then we will be able to create the reports that it's like the same that I used to have with Universal Analytics, with data that really matters for us and that can really help us to redefine and refocus our strategies. And well, of not, if you really don't like GA4 and you wanted to change it completely, there's also a library where you can publish and unpublish reports and create your own and manage it however you want, but this will be another talk. So hope you like it. And thanks a lot.